Hello, welcome to World 3 with the Necromancer. To be honest, you really need the forest and the rivers to, you know, make this work. Otherwise, the Necromancer is pretty weak in World 3, but with the forest, the deserts and the rivers, you actually have a big chance. Now, I have to explain a lot of things. First of all, it's RNG-based. If you get the Unseen Care, that's amazing. You might as well win the mission. So this trait over here basically depends on you winning the mission or not. If you don't get that, well, we can say goodbye, because we'll never have enough HP to survive it. The Shield of Faith helps, but in this order: Unseen Care, Age of Impossible, and then the Art of Control, in any order you like. Sometimes I prefer these two over everything else, but these two are also very good. As you can see, I've only placed the sand dunes and the thickets mostly, and it depends on your map how you place the river. To be honest, it's not so important, because I could have placed the deserts and the forest to fill all of this up. Now, I'm only using a lot of vampires just because I want to fight all the zombies, and then I want to have the bookeries near them so I get the replacement cards. Without, this is something people don't really tell you, but without the bookeries, which swap your cards when you pass near them, it's almost impossible to get the thickets and the sand dunes, because you'll only get the forest and the deserts most of the times. So yeah, you need that. Also, because of the forest, I'm actually spawning the villages. A village? Question mark. So my goal over here was to kind of spread all over the map and have the entire loop area covered with a village, because they're pretty easy to fight. I mean, you still get hit by your own attack, because you will attack as well with your necromancer, and you can still get the retail damage, but most of the times your skeletons do all of the job. If your magic HP enough, you don't have to worry about it. So a village is kind of like the easiest encounter you can get, and besides, it's a lot of loot. Otherwise, Grimoire is over here. I should have started with this one. Grimoire, ring, amulet, and ring. To be honest, I didn't prepare for this, and it was basically a lot of luck involved in these things. Max skeletons, this is perfect. This Grimoire is perfect. This ring is, whatever. This amulet is whatever. Okay, as you can see, there are a lot of things that go into this one. I'm basically using the Count's Lands to heal, because that's the only health I get. As you can see, my regeneration is basically zero, so that means I rely on the villages and the Count's Land for healing. So let's see where we have some. Have one over here, one over here, one over here, just in case if things got out of control. And I also have the Fishman. Because you will not spawn enough enemies in the beginning. The spiders are pretty bad. They have no souls, they can swarm you, they can destroy skeletons very fast. They also pair up very, very bad with the vampires, because they will almost kill you. So I spawned over here 3 reeds. Also, I tried to spawn some shipwrecks, but I don't remember if I fought the sirens or not. Who knows? We'll fight it right away. Okay, let's go. Well, looks like we have also a stall, so you'll stay. Hunter sound. 100 HP, oh, they are very dangerous. If he... what? Okay, this is bad translation. Damage is increased by 100% and 50% max HP is healed after the death of an ally. Okay, so they go to another planet, and then when they come back, they attack. Oh, you look like a demented hunter. Not the most polite. The good thing I said, yeah, you could have said, hey, want some kibble? I feed it to my dogs. Oh, he was talking to his dogs. Know your place, dog. Okay, he still got... just know your place, dog. Who are you? To kill the whole herd in the pen, but not without the reason, of course. And as you start killing them, a couple of bulls break the fence and escape into the forest. But that won't do. You need to kill every one of them. That's the point, you know. And that is where the hunter comes in. He'll track down every rebellious bull and shoot it. Well, that doesn't sound polite. Oh, don't even try to tell me about politeness. Right, is it of you not only to avoid world annihilation, but to resist this magnificent process? Well, you know. All of you have this profound and wonderful motivation to participate in this cataclysm, and every one of you ignores the fact that We all want to keep living. It stinks to be exterminated, you know, exactly. That's why you're controlling the undead, which are basically... Well, let's just say our armies get exterminated a lot. Frankly speaking, I don't give a damn. I think this is a reference to the movie on Wing... I don't know the title in English. Gone with the Wind, I think, is the movie. Frankly speaking, I don't give a damn. Yeah, this is surely a reference from that movie. I enjoy hunting. I'll feed the remnants of your world to my hounds. They'll eat it all in one bite. As if their stomachs were black holes. Well, they are made of black holes. I just like the jokes. You may get my joke very soon. Get him. Woof. Okay, now things will get very, very scary and crazy. Let's see if we actually get him. Oh, he deals damage himself. So he can summon a kennel that increases the damage, okay. Kills the hounds attack by 50% every second, attack Stargon powder to stop attacking. Oh, he never misses. Well, I don't have evasion with me. So I guess this is why people were angry about him. He never misses. Okay, let's hope we get a lot of skeletons. These guys have 105 because we are level 7. Okay, looks like... So what's happening now? The hunter's dogs are getting attacked. He's attacking us. We are attacking him a little bit. We have the archers going on. We're not taking any damage because of the skeleton guards. We only have 250 magic HP. So if he gets through our HP, we'll be in problem. What? Looks like he's reloading. Okay, this is the best situation we can have. We have skeleton warriors, three of them. The mage, which is the same thing as the archer, but this has magic damage. So that means their defense won't help against magic damage. This is a super important thing. Same damage? Okay, let's go. Oh, so if you attack them enough times, they cannot be targeted anymore. Okay, we killed one hound. We killed the second one. Aha, that was too much fun. What a shame. Cornered by my own target and killed. Now tell me everything you know. I don't really think that is the moment when I acknowledge your power and tell you all I know out of sheer respect, you know. Do I have to kill you a lot more times? I'm dying here, you know. It's not a great time for revelations. And also, you kill my hounds, you bet. Well, they're not technically dead. They'll be revived soon enough. And also, they're black holes. I don't think you can destroy the black holes. And you think I feel good about that? Yeah, we killed astral doggies. I was sorry about even the leech. So imagine for the dogs and this guy. Don't confuse your motivation with mine. I hope you don't have this annoying habit of coming back to life unharmed, do you? Right now while I'm dying, a new body has already been made for me in the heart of the greatest black hole. Well, at least we can watch you die. Yes, I'll be back. My hands shan't continue and there's no place in the universe where I couldn't track you down. You don't have to make things so complicated. I'm not going anywhere and I'm not going to hide. I feel better knowing that you're wasting your time fighting me instead of destroying the other worlds. I hear the sound of a horn and the barking of my loyal hounds. A new hunt begins. A new hunt. Yeah, these guys give me hope. They wouldn't waste their time on me if I wasn't a real threat to their goal. So now we'll actually unlock new perks. Killing an enemy will deal 2 or so. Okay, so that means if we are in loop 8, this will deal 16 extra damage. Doesn't sound too good. As a shot, as a chance to reflect a ranged shot into a random enemy. To be honest, you don't really get shot by a ranged attack so often, unless you want it. Now, this is something we can release, the bottomless battle. This is actually interesting because we might need to have the extra damage in order to kill people, especially in the beginning. Oh yeah, we'll just take the Hunter's Mark. I mean, we'll unlock the skill. Now, usually I just end the turn. Okay, let's stay. Because I want to fight the Siren. Look at that. I think that's the Siren. Okay, let's actually see what he gave us. Maybe there's something good. You know, I think there is only one way to play the Necromancer, and this is only to get the best items. So if they have all of the stats, meaning level, quality, and skeleton level, that will be perfect. Otherwise, it's very hard to justify taking something. Even something like this is very hard to take. Summoner Quar. What? This is a level 10 and only 29. That's embarrassing. Okay, those zombies die very hard. So let's see if we can finish our dunes, and I mean, I will play a little more. Yeah, we can put another village over there. Okay, we have another elf village. Honestly, I don't know where we can take the river right now. Seems like it's stuck. Okay, we'll have to see about that. By the way, these things helped me so much. I mean, the chests are something that you really need because you have a lot of artificial life. But the loot you get from the chest and the scarecrows is just too good. Now let's see. It's quality level. Nope. Nope. So let's see if we unlock the Siren entry. Yeah, it's not going to work. I mean, you really need everything to be level 6 at least. Level 7 works better. Otherwise, the guards will get killed too easy. Oh, and by the way, never take the perk that shares the damage between you and the skeletons, because that will kill your ranged line very fast. And you don't want that. Wow, my attack speed is 243. I don't even think that matters anymore. Okay, this is 268. Look at it going. That was the vampire lady, sorceress. So that was 4. That means we summon 8 skeletons or something like that. I mean, we can basically make it everywhere. Also, I don't really use the wheat fields anymore. There's simply no point in using them, especially because they are near the book or something like that. So, the rest of the free spaces will be covered by a village. Maybe I'll put down more battlefields, because you never have enough of these. Yeah, let's make this shipwreck over here, and also the blood path. I think I'll only make this one loop, and then I'll end the loop anyway. Because to be honest, this is not a perfect run, this is far from perfect. But as long as I have these two, it's okay. But I learned a lot of things from this, especially with the vampire mages and the chest. Okay, so let's see. I guess we can't improve any more on this unless they give us higher tier gear, which is not likely. Attack speed 24%. Yeah, that's not going to work over here. Those tomes are so strong. Now, this is something I could work with, but to be honest, I don't want to roll my lower my quality at all at this point. I mean, you really need these strings to be the rare ones, like this one, that have 4 abilities. I'm thinking about it. But no, it's not really worth it. No. Definitely not worth it. Also, the scarecrows scare away the vampires, so they're actually pretty easy to kill and give good loot. Okay, so that was our heal. Now let's see the vampire mages and the ghouls. To be honest, I think they're a little easier. As you can see, they deal 66 damage. They can heal some of their allies. Again, that's not so important. The most important thing is that they have a soul. Of course. They also have a soul. Yeah, I think the attack speed is kept because I don't really see any difference between 200% and 247. He gets up, he gets back down. Go to sleep. This is like that Hulk scene where, you know, Iron Man says go to sleep, go to sleep. Nothing special? Okay, so the river goes where? At this point, you start the river from here. And if you manage to get it blocked, that's it. You can't continue with it any longer. I started from here and we can't go back and loop around. So that's kind of like a bad thing. Right now this card is useless. I might as well put... no, actually let's leave it like this. Okay. Right now basically all of my cards are useless. I can't really play anything else. Okay. Oh no, that was the siren. Oh, you dirty scarecrow, you scared away the siren before I could kill it and know it. It didn't trigger a dialogue, so I'm not sure about that. I think we have another siren over there. Okay, let's go up there. Do I have an oblivion card? That wouldn't help. I guess we just have to get lucky and don't scare away the siren. This could also be interesting because it has 7 levels. Okay, we're getting some dunes, 41% HP. And we're still getting health because we're killing stuff with souls. Ah well, they switched my cards but nothing really good came out of it. Okay, these don't have a soul. I forgot to check that. Also, those ghosts help you a lot. So, the ghosts that you can summon actually are very, very good for you because they can have extra items and they're pretty good as well. Killing the extra enemies in that combat will help you quite a lot. So, in a way, this is kind of like the only combination I found where you could kill everything so good. Okay, no one scared away the siren this time, so let's see. Humidity lover, slimy effect if there are liquid enemies in battle. I think this is liquid. Yes, it's liquid. Oh, she has evasion then. Protected. Well, nothing much. She deals a lot of damage. This is quite a bad combination of enemies for me. Blood clot, okay. Cannot be targeted. Just look at the amount of cards I'm getting and also the loot. Oh, anyway, that's all I wanted to show you. See you next time. Bye.